but the importance of having that clarity, that vision. When thinking about Steve Jobs saying, he said, we cannot connect the dots forwards. We only can connect the dots backwards.
How many of you here who would like to make a change?
Gaining clarity. Hi, my friends. Today, topic is all about gaining clarity, helping you to define what you want, what is the next level in your life, and your best self. With that, you can direct your energy, your focus, your daily habits to achieve that next level, your best self. And before talking about how can we do that, let's talk about the importance of having clarity, because I think that we don't practice it well enough. And I myself sometimes didn't practice it well enough. Recently, I had a meeting. I didn't prepare to remember the exact address, so my phone went flat, no battery. I didn't write on my notebook. I didn't know that address exactly. I just knew the road. I went to there, I went around and asking people, how could people know? Because I didn't remember the number of the address. So I had to go to the coffee shop and ask to log into my email and file the exact address. If I had that exact address, the clarity about where I wanted to go, I didn't need to spend that much time. And for sure, I had to be more careful and prepare better. But you can see the idea here is that because I didn't know where I wanted to go exactly, so I wasted my time and effort. And it's happened in the case that if you use GPS to go to a new place and you didn't know where the new place, where the address. So Google, even Google, that intelligent Google cannot help you to direct you from where you are now to where you want to go. And I also remind myself about the importance of having that clarity, that vision. When thinking about Steve Jobs saying, he said, we cannot connect the dots forwards. We only can connect the dots backwards. iPhone, think about Apple's, they make different iPhones. And if they don't have a clear vision about the next iPhone, how does it look like? They cannot know how they need to program or design to make that iPhone happen, to launch that new iPhone. And even similar, when you go to the supermarket, then you don't have the list of the things that you want to buy. Then how can you direct your energy when you go there? You either buy a lot of things or buy nothing, and you go home and you may blame yourself. So not having that clarity, that really consumes time, energy, and effort. So that's why we want to spend our time to practice to gaining that clarity, to take a pen and paper and now write down about what we want to achieve, my friends. So let's join me. Firstly, let's talk about different areas in your life. And now you can talk about your health, you can talk about your relationship, you can talk about your finance, you can talk about the adventure in your life. So let's take our health as an example, because we both know without health, even we have other things, we cannot enjoy it. If you have a pen and paper and notebook now, you can define the first column and the second column on your paper. And the first column, you will identify your current health level. If you need to evaluate from 0 to 10, how you see your health right now? The current level probably 7 out of 10, or 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10, or 10 out of 10, even 10 out of 10. What would be the next 10 out of 10 in the next year, next month? And for my case, for example, I would see myself currently 8 out of 10, and the next level is 9 out of 10. And to have that next level, I know that I need to make yoga become the main exercise, at least 1 hour, because before that, I always did like running, aerobics, cardio, and yoga around like 20 minutes and 30 minutes daily, some day like 40 minutes. But now I would like to make it at least 45 minutes per day, at least 45 minutes per day, and then I can feel the vibrant, the energy, and also calm and flexibility, mobility. So that is where I lead my health to the next level. And also I add badminton 3 times per week to my calendar, and that is also to maintain that next level of my health. What about your case? I would like you to evaluate that and then define the next level, and then you can know what action you need to take. And with that, I now would like you to join the next exercise to gain clarity of your best self. If you need to identify your best identity, you want to use 3 adjectives to describe it. What would it be? And with that best self, clear vision, you know your daily habits need to align with that. For example, in my case, that I always want to view myself as a passionate person, and I still live up to that person every single day. Whenever in any situation, my behaviors, I say, okay, whether I am in my best energy as I can, whether I'm in my best passionate self as I can. And also I recently always remind myself to integrate the patient identity into me. So whenever in any situation, when I answer anyone email, I will say, okay, if I am a patient person, how would I actually answer the email instead of reacting? So my friend, having that 3 words to describe your best self, you can direct your behaviors, your habits, and it become a part of you after you do it long enough, daily, consistently enough. And I remember when I shared that practice in a leadership talk in Ho Chi Minh City last week, one of my friends told me that, oh, she actually also had that practice, and she actually lived up to that person and became that person, and other people could feel that person in her, and her 3 words actually make it become SOS, and the O stand for organized, and I could see it clearly in the way she organized the meeting. So my friends, 3 words describe your best self and make it become your slogan. And company has slogan, and now you have slogan for yourself, so you can live up to that. And now you also want to have the clarity about your feeling. You know that is your best self. What about the feeling you want to feel every single day? You really want to define clearly the 3 feelings make you feel happy, make you feel vibrant, make you feel that you live truly. And then with that, you also make it become the guidance for your daily habit. For example, you want to have the vibrant feeling. And now any situation, you say that if you're exhausted, you say, okay, what can I do to actually have that vibrant feeling? Maybe I'm gonna make a move, maybe I'm gonna take a deep breath, maybe I'm gonna meditate, maybe I'm gonna just go for a walk. So having that feeling and that identity, best self, it guides your daily action, daily habits. So the important thing is that you identify them and you have it with you, and with that, you remind you to live up to that, to behave in that, to make it strongly be a part of you. And with that, you have that clarity, you keep practicing and you keep taking action, you will keep non-stop loving, living and giving every single moment of life. I see you in the next video.